I can't tell you how many times I speak with clients and they say that they're already using Airtable in their business, but they have a different software that they're using to track their project management. There's really no need for this because you can abandon any other software that's specific to project management and build your project management tool directly in Airtable. So if this pertains to you and you want to learn more about how you can track your project management in Airtable, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting. It's my mission here to help you get the full potential from your no-code tools, specifically Airtable. And we're going to be diving into Airtable today, showing how it can be leveraged for project management. Now, if you're new here, before we get going, I want to invite you to join me for some free templates. My team and I have compiled the 5 most common Airtable use cases that we see with our clients, and we gave them to you in 5 easy-to-digest templates. You can sign up for free at gapconsulting.io/templates. But without further ado, let's go ahead and hop on into my screen. I'm going to get started by building an app. And frankly, I'm going to cheat a little bit and use AI. Now, I will try to tell you throughout the video when I'm using a feature that is on an upgraded tier. And AI is definitely one of those paid features. You have to toggle this on for your workspace if you're going to be able to build with Airtable's co-builder. Because I do a lot of building for clients, this is a no-brainer for my team. So we are using AI a lot. But here's what my prompt looks like. And by the way, I don't claim to be an AI prompt master of any kind, but this is my best stab at it. So I'm saying, hey, help me build a solution for project management. And then I list out my tables and fields. So I call out what tables I'm using and then what field types I want to include within that table. And when I click next, it's going to start building this app for me. Now, the great value of using Airtable AI, if you have the ability to do that on your plan, it's going to build the back end, the co-builder, but it's also going to build the front end. So it's going to put together some interfaces that we may or may not want to use. Now, in full transparency, when I do start with an AI co-builder, there's usually a lot that I have to go in and clean up on the back end. So this is not going to get you a 100% complete solution most of the time. But it's going to get you pretty close. So I've told Airtable what I want to include. I'm going to just trust that it did a pretty good job here. And we're going to say create this app. By the way, if you wanted to poke around right here, you could have poked around in the interface and just explored it a little bit to make sure that you like what Airtable is putting together. But as I've been talking, I haven't really paused or cut too much here. The truth is, this is really fast. It's standing up a good amount of this database for me. I'm probably going to have to do a little bit of rewiring on the background, but this is your first big tip for, frankly, building anything in Airtable. If you can leverage the co-builder, this is going to help you save a ton of time. But now let's go ahead and hop on into the app. You can see that I can edit the app and I can publish the interfaces, or I can go right to the data layer, which is where I want to head. So let's poke in here. We've got projects. This is pretty normal for any kind of project management. And I did call this out specifically when I asked Airtable to build this. Now you'll also notice that it's connected to assigned team and it's connected to tasks. Now, if you are trying to limit what people can see inside of their Airtable interface, for example, you might want people to only see the tasks that are assigned to them. Well, this is a great way to do that. Because over here on the teams table, we can flip on over. You can see we've got these 4 different team names. Imagine these are internal teams. And what we can do here is actually add in users from Airtable. Now, if you wanted to make tasks available at a team level, we can add the Airtable users directly right here. So let me show you what that might look like. We can bring in the Airtable user. It's called the user field type, and I'll just name this Airtable user. And we can choose to allow multiple users, which we want for teams. And then we can also choose whether or not people will get a notification when they're added here. Let's toggle that off. And you can see that we can bring in a default user. And there are 2 people in my organization that I could assign right now. Now, if you were sharing or creating this internally, your people on your team would all be able to access the things that you limit to them. So we can build interfaces, and I'm going to show you this in a moment, so that people can access only their tasks. So at this level, we are assigning Airtable users to a team. If you wanted to get a bit more granular, you could also create a users table, which I'll demonstrate for you here. So let's imagine we start from scratch and we create a users table. You could name the different users inside of your organization. And in this case, I have both Gareth and Sarah within my organization. So let's go ahead and use them as an example here. You can bring in the Airtable user here. And when you assign them here, then you can link these people to the different teams. And if you want to get even more specific, you can create yet another table, which I'm not going to demonstrate in the interest of time, but you could actually create a roles table where you say, Gareth is attached to this team and he has this particular role. And with that kind of leveling, permissioning, you can create even more customizable interfaces for your system. But for our simpler example, we can create a link here from users to teams. And let's just go ahead and create this field. And now over here on the team side, remember where we added the Airtable user directly to the team's table? Well, for a lot of project management, you might not want it here. Instead, you're going to look at linking a user to a team. So let's say Gareth and Sarah were both on this particular team. And remember that we have their user at the user level. We have their Airtable account. So this allows us to then look up. We can bring in a lookup field and bring in that user ID. So now, anytime that this particular team is assigned to a new project and various tasks within that project, we can filter in who is on that team and then make sure that people only see their specific tasks. So for the purpose of this example, let's keep in mind that Gareth and Sarah were both assigned to the Dreamweavers team. Now let's flip on over to projects again and take a look at how else this is associated. So we've talked about teams, but now we also have the tasks component here. So let's flip into tasks and see what's happening. So a task is connected to a project. We have a task due date, and then of course a calculation that's telling us how many days until this is due. Now bear in mind, this was all created by AI, which I'm pretty excited about. This is pretty good stuff. Now, if we want to get a little bit more granular at the task level, let's say that a task does not get assigned to a team, but instead a task gets assigned to a user. There's a couple of ways you can think about building this logic. Now, the easy way is to just connect your tasks table to your users table, or you can just use the Airtable user field that I demonstrated earlier, and you can add it right here in the tasks. This is the simple way to do it. We're going to do a slightly more complicated interpretation in our example, though. So let's go ahead and not plug in the user directly here. Let's discard this. Let's assume instead, for every task, a task is assigned to a project, and a project is assigned to a team. So we can look up what users are on a team. So we're going to do that first. This is adding a lookup field. We're going to look up the users. And in this case, I'm looking up the user from users, and I want to look up the users itself. This will make sense in a moment. User from users is the Airtable user. So I'm just going to rename this Airtable user. And it's plural, so I should add an S. And then we also have the lookup to the users, which is the users that are on the team. So remember, Gareth and Sarah are on the Dreamweavers, which is why they're bringing in here. And then because we know they're Airtable users, it's coming in here. Now, this might not make sense yet, but it should at the end, because this Airtable user is going to allow us to filter down really easily so that when people log into that interface, they see the tasks assigned to them. But we're still not at the task level. Now what we want to do is create a link from our tasks so that our users are conditional based on the fact that the team is associated with this project. That's a lot, right? There's a lot of layers here. So let's break this down step by step. So first, what I need to do is add a link to my users table. I'll come in here and add a link to users just like this. And I will toggle off multiple records, meaning that we will only ever assign one user to a task. So when I create this field, you'll see that I have a list of my two users, but we only have two users. So let's add some other users just as an example. I'll add a Kevin and I'll add a Samantha. And I'll flip back now to tasks and demonstrate that all four of the different users are available. But only two people are on the Dreamweavers team. So we're going to use a little feature called dynamic filtering. So we want to make sure that when we look at a list of people, they are the people that are assigned to this project. So how can we do that? Let's go ahead and flip into users. And on the users table, we are going to bring in the projects. So we'll do a lookup field to the projects. And we can inherit the projects that are assigned to users by looking at the teams. Because at the teams level, we have a link to projects. So what we're able to do is kind of reach through the extra layer of data. We're saying, hey, Dreamweavers, we know that you are connected to two different projects. What are they? We can find the Dreamweavers team, and essentially the lookup field is pulling the data from the team's table and bringing in the projects that are assigned to the respective teams. And so that's now being brought in at the user level. So if Kevin was assigned to a different team, let's say the Code Warriors, you're going to then see whatever projects the Code Warriors are assigned to here. Now let's flip back into tasks. This is a little complicated, so follow it step by step. We're going to now do that dynamic filtering. We're going to click into the user link. We're going to filter the record by a condition. And the condition that we're going to use has to do with the projects. We want to say that the projects that we just added to the users table is dynamically linked to the associated project for any given task. So let's back up, confirm this change, and think about what this means. This means that for this particular task, because it's associated with the Galactic project, and of course we know what team is associated to that project, when we click on users, we're going to only see the users on the team, the Dreamweavers. And similarly here, I can say, hey, I want to know, I only want to see the different team members who are on the Code Warriors, because we know that the virtual reality project is assigned to the Code Warriors. So this is a way that you can dynamically filter down so that you don't see the full list of all your team members and you make sure that you're assigning tasks to people that they should be assigned to. This is a big takeaway for any kind of project management, and it can be a little confusing at first, but follow along and you'll get there. Now let's head into another key feature for Airtable, and that is the interfaces. So these were also built inside of our AI, and you can see that we have views for the project list, a project timeline, and teams here as well. So let's go ahead and publish these really quickly. We'll publish both of them and kind of poke around and see what they're all about. So an interface is a great way for you to share access to the data layer, but only share the stuff that you want your team to see. And as I've been talking about, since we are assigning things to people here in Airtable, we want to make sure that when they log in and they look at their tasks, that they only see the task that they've been assigned. So to that end, we're going to need to go back into the data layer here. And I haven't quite pulled through the user itself yet because we have the link to the users, but we need that Airtable user. So let's bring that in here. We're going to add a lookup field and bring in the Airtable user. Remember, that's the specific field type. And because Gareth has one here, we know what that is. So ideally, when I log into my tasks interface, I will only see this particular task. Of course, we'd want to build another interface for management so that they could see all tasks and due dates. So let's go ahead and build that interface now that we have the Airtable user finally brought in here correctly. So back on the interface side of things, we're going to create a new page. We say edit pages, and this is our kind of edit mode inside of interfaces. We can add a page within interfaces. So a page is this component right here where we have project list or project timeline. The interface is called projects. So you can have multiple pages within an interface. And when you create new pages, everybody who has access to the interface sees all of those pages. So let's create a new page inside of our projects here. I'll click on add a page, and we can make it, let's make it a list view. That's fine. So we can say tasks is the source data here. We want to bring in the different tasks and see them. We could do this on a calendar. We can do this on a record review. There really are a lot of different options to you in terms of the way you visualize your data. I prefer the list view in a lot of cases, but notice here that we've got a lot of different visualizations like timeline, calendar. Kanban is great for task management, so we might make that available as well. And there we are. So how do we sort down and make sure that people only see their stuff? There's a couple of ways we can do it. We can add filters to the entire page. That's one option. So if we want to do that, notice that my blue outline is around the entire page here. I can then select filter by, and I can say the user, and we're looking for that Airtable user, that specific field type. And here we can say current user. And if we did this, that would mean that whoever is logged in can only see their stuff. This is the perfect way to do it. As soon as I do that, because I'm the one editing and I'm only assigned to one task, I only have one task available on the list. Now, maybe I don't want to do that at the top level. If I do it at the page level, at the top level, then that means I can never kind of break it down and see the bigger picture. So maybe I want to be able to see a bigger picture. In that case, I might add the filter at the user filter option. So let's imagine what this would look like. Let's create a drop down here where I could, for example, add not the task status, we can ditch that, but I'll go into the properties of that filter and say, no, I really care about the user. And I can set a default condition as well to be the current user. So if I publish these changes, then what happens is when I log in, it will default to me, the current user. When somebody else logs in, it will default to them. But we still have the access or the ability to remove that and look at all of the tasks. See how that works? So there's a default setting here that we've applied. So when we log in, we're going to see our stuff, but we can still look at the big picture. This is a really, really helpful feature if you're building interfaces and deploying to any number of people greater than one. So what else do we want to do here? Well, we've got tasks and we need to manage them. So we can look at our fields and choose what fields we're going to show up here. So we might really care about days until due. We might not care about task priority. We might really care about task description. You get the idea. We can bring in the fields that are relevant to us by making them visible here, and we can rearrange them by dragging them within the ordering here. You can also resize the columns and essentially create or cultivate the exact visibility that you want people to see in terms of what data do they need access to. Now, when it comes to editing this information, you can allow them to edit records in line. If you toggle this on, they can just start typing right in line and make updates. If you keep this toggled off, that's okay. They can still edit, and we can give them permission to edit with even more control by allowing them to open up the record. So now they can actually pop into the record, and there's a detail modal that pops up here. This is a record detail, and we can go item by item here and choose what we want them to be able to edit by clicking editable on the side panel. So we can again highlight here and say editable, right? User, we might want to reassign somebody, or maybe not. Maybe this is too much information. We just want to see the name. We have full control, full customization over our Airtable interfaces. When we're happy with the way they look, we click publish, and then we can give them a little test run. And as you'll see right here, I can then update my status quite easily. Now, you might remember that we also toggled on the Kanban view, and I can flip over to it by accessing it right here. And it looks like it has grouped them by the status automatically. I can again control how this plays out by editing the page, but you can see that it has a pretty good understanding and my filter carries through. So again, if I toggle this off, I'm going to see all the different tasks, or if I toggle it back on, you know, I'm only seeing the stuff I'm assigned to. So project management is all about task management in Airtable, making sure that people can see the stuff that they are responsible to complete, share the proper information, allow them to edit, ask questions. A whole other thing that we didn't talk about is the ability to add comments right here. You can collaborate directly in the app by mentioning right here. You can add reference people, leave some notes, and now you've got a nice little thread here that's going to show you everything that's happening. You can receive notifications. You can emote on these different things by adding reactions. Like, you've got a lot of options when it comes to collaboration and, you know, just overall project management. So hopefully this video has inspired you to set out and rebuild perhaps your existing project management software inside of Airtable. Listen, if you're already paying for Airtable to manage other parts of your business, why aren't you managing your projects there too? If you have any questions that we didn't answer, feel free to swing by our website. We would love to help you. Of course, if you got value from this, a thumbs up and a subscription to the channel would really help us out, and it would go a long way. Most importantly though, my friends, keep on building.